Well, we're getting closer and closer to summertime, and that means you and the kiddos can spend a lot of time in the sun, going outside, and a few serious sunburns can increase your child's risk of skin cancer later in life. Let's discuss that. Dr. John Zanis, a board certified with the American Board of Plastic Surgery, with some sun safety tips for kids. And this weekend, maybe the first one, doctor, the pools are opening. It's going to be, 80 degrees and sunny, and some of us forget to put on the sunblock.
We all forget, myself included. You know, it's something you hear about all the time. Wear sunscreen, protect your skin. But what we often forget is that it's not just going to the beach or the pool. It really should be something that we do every single day, even during winter.
Really? Just put it on just to make it a habit?
If you can make it a habit, that will probably be the number one best thing you can do to protect your skin from aging, wrinkling, as well as, more importantly, skin cancer and serious problems later on.
Okay, so for kids, you know, they want to run out. We live near the pool, and they want to run out and go to the pool real quick, and sometimes they sneak out and forget to put stuff on. Because it is work, right? But it's so important to put it on. Is there a particular product of the, you know, the sprays versus the lotions that you recommend?
They're all good for different reasons. This is just an assortment of various brands. No one is better than any other. But what's important is that, number one, it's broad spectrum. So that means it covers both UVA and UVB radiation. And so most of these are all broad spectrum. SPF 35 or higher should be fine. Once you get past that, it doesn't really make a whole lot of difference.
Now, see, when I was a kid, I'm going to grab one of these here. It doesn't really matter which one. This is a spray, and this is a 70. Well, back in my day, the big one was 10.
Yeah.
So why has the sun become that much, you know, seven times more powerful that I need this now?
Not quite, but we've learned more and more that even a little bit of tan, which looks good.
Right, it does.
Is considered sun damage. It's damage to the skin. And so we're really trying to prevent early on in life any sun damage to the skin, which later can cause dangerous cancers like melanoma.
What about reapplication? You know, the kids are in the pool. They all say they're waterproof, but how long is that really the case?
First of all, you should definitely apply prior to sun exposure. 15, 30 minutes at least. So you can't put on the sunscreen at the beach. Put it on before you get there. And reapplication is definitely key every 2 to 3 hours, even though the ones say waterproof or water resistant,
right,
it comes off with sweat or with swimming.
I like the zinc ones. I had, when I went down to Myrtle Beach recently, it was pink.
Yeah.
So I painted my nose pink and I looked kind of foolish, but it was fun. I like doing stuff like that. But those work as well?
These are all sunscreens,
right,
which are chemicals that absorb the radiation. The zinc oxide ones are more of a sunblock, and what sunblock does is it physically prevents the sun's radiation from getting to
your skin. Yeah, see, there's a bad, I saw a lot of that at Myrtle Beach as well.
Yeah, and that previous one you saw, it was just, what can I reach? The rest gets burned.
Yeah, and that's the issue. Doctor, appreciate the time. One just real quick question for those who go out with like oil, like Nick Koser. He wears oil instead of anything. I think it's like baby oil.
Is that, yeah. is that-